before Yulu, as you know, I was running in Mobi, and in Mobi I had a very incredible journey building a business from scratch on mobile advertising, which when we started did not exist. And when I was 20 years ago, I thought I should be an entrepreneur by 30, and that promise I fulfilled when I turned 30 in Mobi got started. And then during that time I thought I should be retiring when I am 40 years old. And when I started reaching 40 years old milestone, I realized that that's not me. Probably I need something more food for thought and some more thing to challenge myself intellectually. And that's where I thought of picking up a problem with a social impact, and looked at various problems. Unfortunately, India has a lot of problems, but fortunately, entrepreneurs like us, we see an opportunity. And that's what happened to me. Looked at healthcare, education, water, but finally I picked traffic congestion and traffic and air quality to be a problem that I should be putting my next 10 years, because I thought that these problems also impact me as an individual. So that was my reason of starting Yulu. At the same time, I believe that any journey starts from a first step. And when you are a startup, you have very limited resources. You are playing in a new category where you do not know what our problems you're going to face. So while electric energy has been a good thing for us, electric mobility has been a good thing for us, but imagine if we go just too big and then realizing, oh my God, I missed this part. And unlike a software where you can put an update overnight, the scooter which is on the road, you cannot just change it overnight. It's going to be a lot of money. So instead of we just thinking that let's dump these scooters on day one, we thought of doing a very, you know, approach which was taking the city not at a time, but taking a neighborhood in a city, typically a 20-25 square kilometer, and then launch Yulu service. And after we get comfortable around our operations, product market fit, launch it in a second neighborhood and third neighborhood, and over a period of 2 years, you complete the entire city. So our vision is to do big things, but we think that you always need a focused effort to get things right. So that has been our approach, and thankfully it has worked well for us. So no complaint. So if you look at world globally, mobility is now becoming smart and shared. Started by Uber and then bunch of companies across the globe, they started this revolution. Now look at our Indian context. We have 25 cars among 1,000 people. Same number for United States is 850. And what is interesting that, you know, even if you talk about taking this number to 30, our roads have no space. Look at our cities, already clocked. And for us, the solution is not more car when it comes to mobility, which is becoming also smart and shared. In our case, it has to be also becoming small. And the fourth component, which I think is a global phenomena, it is air quality for India. It can be a global climate, a global warming issue for European city or an American city. I think our challenges are same. So mobility paradigm globally has become shared, smart, small and sustainable. And I think this is what India will follow. Now, interestingly, the way India never had landlines, we never had this credit card, we leapfrogged. We leapfrogged to the better future. Same thing I believe will happen in India, that most of our mobility will move to this new paradigm of mobility. When we look at the world 3 years or 5 years from right now, you completely say, oh my goodness, I never imagined this will happen in India. But you have seen as a fellow citizen how our country changes like overnight, and this is a belief I have got. Answer is yes, that's a belief, and that's where I think now everyone tends to believe and understand. Earlier we were thinking that maybe we should electrify the personal cars, not worth it. Then we understood that it should be either two-wheeler or three-wheeler. That's too, when I have to buy a vehicle, you know, then I have to worry about range anxiety, resale value, financing, bunch of these challenges. Not easy, Trust me, when you write a check for 80,000 rupees, 1 lakh, it's not that easy. But when I say that you give me 10 rupees, 30 rupees, take this product from A to B, you say, yeah, why not? It's cheaper, it's better, it's convenient. You have no resistance. And that's where I think the now general outlook and understanding among the group is that it will be two-wheeler and three-wheeler. That too in a model where mobility is given to you as a consumer in a service model, where you know for sure that it is better and cheaper, and hence your reason for switching to a cleaner, better, efficient mode is very clear, and there is no, you know, resistance towards that, and that's why the adoption will be very, very high.